patient is allowing you to work on his face, inside his mouth, the very delicate areas of his body, he's trusting you with that. So if you cannot provide that comfort level to your patient, definitely he won't return back to you, no? But if you can, then he will come back to you and next time he'll bring more patients as well.
Hi guys, and today we have a very special guest, Tanya, a third year BDS student from Haldia Institute of Dental Sciences and Research, West Bengal. Thanks for joining.
Thank you for having me.
And today we will talk about the specializations after BDS. So firstly, I would like you to give an outline of the branches of dentistry.
Okay, as per the American Dental Association, there are 8 to 9 branches of dentistry in which you can do a specialization, that is your MDS degree. Now, I'll tell you about those different branches. So, to start off with, we have oral and maxillofacial surgery. Then we have orthodontics and dentofacial orthopedics. Third is prosthodontics. Fourth is conservative dentistry and endodontics. Fifth is pedodontics and preventive dentistry. Sixth, periodontics. Seventh, oral pathology and microbiology. Then we have oral medicine and radiology. And lastly, we have public health or community dentistry. So in your MDS, you can do a specialization on any one of these branches, and that will be decided by your NEET PG rank, that which specialization you will get or which college you will get.
Okay, so could you please tell about the eligibility for a particular specialization?
Yeah, the first thing is you have to be a BDS graduate from any recognized college, any college recognized by the Dental Council of India, that is DCI. After that, you have to sit for NEET PG and you have to qualify NEET PG with a certain rank. You know that NEET PG rank will decide your specialization definitely. Now there are two things, either you prioritize the college or you prioritize the specialization, because both the things together, you cannot have it together, because there are about 7,000 seats for MDS in India, and out of which maybe 40 are in West Bengal. So all the colleges are not having all the seats for all the specializations. So it's kind of divided. So either you, if you have a preference for the particular college, then you have to take whatever specialization you're getting there. So that is your main eligibility criteria, I think, your NEET PG rank. And of course, that you have to be a BDS graduate from a recognized college. And definitely your skill and your knowledge also matters. You know, how you will do in your particular specialization.
Okay, so what are the college preferences for MDS with respect to West Bengal, and then do discuss about with respect to India?
Yeah, so I already told you there are about 40 seats for MDS in West Bengal, which is divided into 3 colleges. Out of that, one is a government college, that is Dr. R. Ahmed College and Hospital. And 2 private colleges, one is Guru Nanak Institute of Dental Sciences and Research, and one my college, that is Haldia Institute of Dental Sciences and Research. So these 40 seats are divided among these 3 colleges in West Bengal. Apart from that, in India, all over India, there are more or less 7,000 MDS seats, and the top ones are definitely AFMC Pune and Maulana Azad in Delhi. But that is, you know, like for the next level students. But in southern India, I know there are actually a good number of colleges that have seats for MDS, and many students actually do pursue MDS from colleges in South India, be it in Chennai or Bangalore or whatever.
Okay, so the highlighted question for today, what are the job opportunities for the different specializations?
Okay, now you will see many people after completing their degree, they actually go into opening their own clinics. Okay, now that is a good option if you are already an heir to a well-established clinic, I would say. Because if you have to start your own clinic just after your degree all by yourself, it requires a lot of investment, whether from the money point of view or your time or energy. It requires a lot of investment. And if you have that much of patience, then you can go for your own clinic. And also you cannot expect to gain that kind of recognition in your initial years only. So running your own clinic is again a good option if you already have a well-established clinic. Otherwise, you can serve as a dental consultant in any private or government hospitals. That is a good option, definitely. Apart from that, there are certain government jobs also, you know, like in the Indian Railways or in Indian Army. But fetching these jobs is not that easy, you know, because you know how things work in India. So if you have a connection there, you kind of like have an upper hand. So you have to look for the vacancies for these jobs, and if you are lucky enough, then you may get these government jobs, and these are actually very good. But and like apart from these, there is also a very big job opportunity, that is you can be a lecturer in a dental college, be it private or government, and then from there you can go on to become an HOD also. So you will be actually like teaching the students, along with it you will be practicing. So that is a very good option. Okay, like personally for me, I feel it's a good option for your job. Now that was in India. Like there are some people who also prefer to like jobs abroad as well, but like jobs in abroad, it's not that easy, you know, it's kind of tedious, because there are countries who actually do not recognize our BDS degree. So it's again like you have to start it all over again. So you give another exam, you have to qualify that, then you have to actually do a separate course which is recognized in their country, then only you can get a license to work there. So it's a tedious process, but definitely that is also one option. And comparatively, it's easier to get a job in the Gulf countries. Okay, so that also in abroad, like from country to country, it will vary, that the different criterias. Yeah, so that was all like about the jobs.
Okay, so lastly, which branch of dentistry has the maximum earning?
Okay, now like first, let me tell you, in India, this is a concept, there's a concept of a general dentist. Okay. There is lack of awareness or whatever you call it. Most of the people don't know that there is a there are specializations in dentistry also. It's like a general dentist who is a jack of all trades. He should know how to do a basic extraction or a root canal treatment or a denture delivery. Everything you expect to like only one person to do everything for you. That is a general dentist. So in India, I think whatever specialization you have, most important for you, first you have to be a general dentist. Okay, that will definitely help you earn a good sum of money. But in abroad, it's definitely not like that. Like, you are actually recognized as a periodontist or a pedodontist, but here that idea is not there because of lack of awareness or whatever. Okay, and specifically now, if you ask me that to name any one specialization which is earning a good sum, I would say it's in orthodontics. Okay, now first let me tell you what it is all about. So basically, orthodontics, it deals with your malpositioned teeth and your malaligned jaws. And you know, in today's world, like how it is, be it the youngsters or the adults, like everyone is concerned, you know, about their look correction. Everybody wants to have a proper jawline, good teeth setting. So number of patients in this field is definitely good. And moreover, let me tell you, like I'm being brutally honest here, like the treatment you will provide here, no, it takes at least a span of 2 to 3 years. So it is like, now this patient becomes your source of income for the next 2 to 3 years. Like, just being brutally honest, but you also have to think from your side. No, now, like, so that's like, now you have a patient, okay, for the next 2 to 3 years. And these are the things definitely, but apart from this, I think some very important things which will definitely have an impact on your earning is that your skill, your knowledge, and what quality of treatment you provide, you know. If you are being able to comfort your patient, because you have to understand, the patient is allowing you to work on his face, inside his mouth, the very delicate areas of his body. He's trusting you with that. So if you cannot provide that comfort level to your patient, definitely he won't return back to you, no. So, but if you can, then he will come back to you, and he, next time he'll bring more patients as well. Okay, like in India, you will see very easily people don't want to go to the dentist, okay, because they can't simply trust the dentist with their face. It's like that, until and unless they can't bear the pain or something like that. So there is also, you know, there is no importance to dental health somewhere or the other, which I feel. But definitely, so like as you asked me about the earning, I was saying, so yeah, your quality of treatment and the way you comfort your patient, these things definitely play an important role in your earning. Okay, and if you have your own clinic, I think the location and the timings of your clinic also play a very important role in your earning. Okay.
Okay, so that was a great discussion. You actually gave clarity over a lot of topics. So looking for more such conversations, I'll put an end to today's conversation. And thanks a lot, Tanya. I guess the audience must have benefited from this speech of yours. And thank you.
Thank you. Thank you so much.